Hopefully I can say something worthwhile. This is my maiden speech. Dan, thanks for your words, but you said your maiden speech was some years ago. So first of all, to thank you very much for what you said, and thank you for the opportunity for, I think, for the CPI members and the Sheepland Association members to be here. I thought I'd start with some advice my father gave me. My father said, son, this was about, I think I was about 17 years old, I was thinking about my career. He says, get into moving money. He says, that's the important thing. He says, if you don't like that, and that's all a bit dirty, get into buying and selling. Just one bit of advice, never get into making anything. Now, he never got as far as politics, and I'm not sure that's because it was above my station, or he considered that even below making things. have to make your own decision. But I was young and foolish and chose manufacturing. And why? Because for me it was a powerhouse of what had made the UK great. The Industrial Revolution, I loved things like science, engineering. This was somewhere to go and work with real integrity and real pride. So that's why I went into manufacturing. Because I wanted to be proud of manufacturing, I wanted to be proud of actually working in the packaging sector. And quite honestly, I get a bit bored of going to dinner parties, because everyone, as my colleagues from the industry will know, you turn up at a dinner party and say what you do, and they go, well, you're killing rainforests and sort of polluting the environment, and it's a terrible thing. Well, I didn't go into manufacturing, I didn't go into packaging for that. I went in because I think we want to make a better world. And I guess you guys in politics are the same. You go in because you want to make a better world. You actually want to do positive things. And the press love to rip us all apart. So I think we're in the same boat a little bit as you guys. So you probably get even worse than we get.
Probably deserve it, to answer.
So three... Three things we're proud of very quickly. We've got a product that's 140 years old since it started, but we didn't leave it there. We've worked really hard to actually get more out of less. We've downweighted papers. We've worked on how we do the corrugating, and we've worked very hard on that so that we aren't the draw on natural resources that we could be. So we're making ever more from stronger materials. We are the UK's favourite packaging material, 30% of the market, and 75% of all transit packaging. So it's a great material to be in. It's flexible medium. We can make it any size you like, and we can decorate it beautifully and provide information for customers. So we see ourselves as a very flexible industry that is powerful in what we can do for the supply chain, the whole supply chain, whether it be right from the producer through the supermarkets through to end users. And the great thing is we do it all sustainably. 80% of all corrugated that used in the UK gets recycled. 76% of the fibre going into corrugated in the UK is recycled. And the thing for the people who aren't mathematicians among us, we recycle an area the size of Greater London every 4 months. So it's quite a feat. And Dan, as you said, where we have to use fibre, and occasionally we have to use fibre because or new fibre, we do that from sustainable forests, which I believe are far better at taking carbon out of the chain than an ancient forest, which is thus left to its own devices. So we're proud of our product, proud of our industry. We've got a turnover of about 1.4 billion. We employ 10,000 people. We have 350 sites, so we're spread right across the country, and we're very well invested, and have a highly skilled workforce, and provide the very sort of jobs that you mentioned that the Smiths provide in Launceston. Although I say Launceston, you say
Lamson.
I thought so, yes. Yeah. I couldn't relearn that in the time I had available. But also, this is the sales pitch. We're proud to offer a win-win situation. And what I mean by that is we want to pay more tax. Now, before you rush away, and I won't get too political, and rush away and think, that's great, let's push up the corporation tax rate. No, we would like a low corporation tax rate, but we want to make more tax because we want to be more profitable, and we pay tax on our profits. So we want an environment where packaging can be growing and more profitable because manufacturing grows and is more profitable. So how can you help us? Because every MP I've ever speak to, just as you finish, says, well, what can I do to help you? I think you must learn that line on the first week. One, realise that the packaging is actually part of the solution, not the problem. For the goods that we package, generally have about 10 times the environmental impact of the packaging. If they don't get to market, if they're wasted, then the environmental impact is very high. And if we have to get the appropriate amount of packaging, not over-package, but certainly not under-package. I think in some economies, 40-50% of the food that's produced doesn't get to market because it's not properly packaged. Well, that's not the case in the UK. I think the figures are at 2% or 3% perhaps. 3%. Sorry, I'm exaggerating. 3%. First of all, we're part of the solution, not the problem. Consider the impact of bureaucracy. We know there are certain things we have to do. There are great things about our country, I think, in the advances made in things like health and safety, and that comes through putting the right legislation in place. But we do need a light touch on the regulatory framework. We particularly need careful thought when it comes to energy policy and balancing decarbonising. I would say a ton of carbon in the UK is exactly the same weight as a ton of carbon in China. The danger is that we exploit our problem if we over-legislate and we put too much pressure here. So I think we do need to have a balanced approach there. And thirdly, create the environment for the right skill base. And we've struggled in our company, and I'm sure I speak for many colleagues in the industry, to get the right skill base. A lot of people think that the arts are an easy option, that people are not taking the STEM subjects, the science, the technology, the engineering and maths. And I think it would be good to really encourage the target to take up to 25% of people taking more than one A-level in a science. That gives us the right sort of graduate. And last of all, publicly supporting manufacturing. We do. We put our money where our mouth is in supporting manufacturing, because basically if it's not made in the UK, generally speaking, the packaging won't come from the UK. So we really want to see the growth of the manufacturing industry. The fact that wages are so much less in Eastern Europe and in China should mean we shut up shop. It should mean we think more carefully and we work harder to increase our efforts to make manufacturing successful in the UK. So I plan to retire in about a decade. So I've sometimes felt during my career that my father was right, until recently when the bankers took a bit of a hammering, that I should have gone into passing money around. But what I'd like in the next 10 years, although he's dead and gone, I'd love to be able to prove him wrong and say manufacturing really came back in the last decade of my career. Particularly the bit that is the packaging industry and the corrugated industry. So please pass on to your colleagues and those colleagues that are here. Come to our sites, see us, visit us, and support us as a part of a very important industry.